Hey, this is some guy named Chris. And yesterday, a client of mine reached out and in Dynamics 365 was wondering if they could reopen a quote. It has been set to one and they want to put it back into the draft status. So, first thing that popped into my head was Power Automate. So, in this video, I want to go through and show you how to reopen a quote using Power Automate. And let's get started. So first thing I'm going to do is go to my environment that has Dynamics 365. And in this case, I'm going to open up the Sales Hub. And I'm going to go to a quote. So the problem, and it's not even a problem, but the issue was with if you look at quote number one, quote one that has been won, you'll see that the record status, it's read-only because it's won. So we want to get it out of read-only. So the way that we can do this is coming to the quote, going to the flow, which is now Power Automate, and we can create a flow. Now, doing this, you'll see that it's actually using the legacy Dataverse. It still works right now, so we can continue. And what we're looking at here is the defaults that we've pulled over from CRM, or sales, I should say. We've got the default environment, which is what we're in. We've got quotes. You can add other inputs. What we're going to do. Let's do a next step. Select Dataverse. And under Dataverse, we are going to update a row. Now we've got a couple things here. One is table name. We're going to come down to quotes. And now, once I selected quotes, we see other fields. Now, we also have the row ID. Now, when you're going through on the dynamic content, we've got different fields here. One of them is a quote ID. This is not the quote ID you would like, you should use. We're going to scroll down a little further, and we're going to use quote. It's the unique identifier for the quote. Now, I mentioned that we want to change the status, so we're going to additional fields. And down here, we're going to change it to draft. Now, one of the things I'll note, show you right here is inside of my status reasons, I've got two in progress. They both go with different drafts, so you aren't getting it. It's not filtering based on the status, so please ensure you know which one it is. If you select the wrong one, it will error out when you execute. It may even work. I'm not sure which one it is yet either. So, what I'm going to do is come up here and say reopen quote demo. Save. We can always do a flow checker. We'll do that as well. No errors, no warnings. Okay, so we're going to go back. We're going to refresh our screen. We're on quote one, still read only. Go to our flows. Make sure. Yep. Okay. So it's gonna be there. Reset a refresh. A couple, maybe again. Yep. So refresh twice, and then we're going to reopen quote demo. We're gonna run the flow. row has been successful, or that has been successful. Let's go back over here. We're going to take a look. Flow is running. Succeeded. So now if we come back in here and we refresh this quote, we can now see that it's actually in the draft in progress status. Power Automate can do a lot of things. One, as you can see, reopening. I would make sure you be careful with this because there are processes and procedures that are in there for a reason. So within your organization, you may or may not want something like this readily available. But this has been Sunday Noon, Chris. Thanks for watching.